Hey everybody, so if you want to be good at something, you have to talk with someone who's great at it. Does it make sense? Okay, we're finally in the jungle gym and today we're going to learn and improve our lache technique. So let's go.
Do you actually know the etymology of the lache word?
I believe it means just to let go.
In the French?
Is it French? In French.
So it's probably from the surface.
Or parkour originated in France, could be it too.
Oh.
From David and Andrew Bell. I introduce any lache as a dismount because I think if you can't safely dismount your distance, why you shouldn't be trying it bar to bar. We're going through a lot of information, so let's just start with the regrab. We're gonna kick forward with our toes, and on the backswing, we're gonna grab more of the bar. Okay. So don't think of it as anything but just grabbing more of the bar because you'll slowly go to your fingertips. Okay. And then when you're ready to go, you bring the toes forward and pop the hips, and we'll just try to land on this line. Nice.
Okay.
And pop the hips.
Where? To fall?
Straight forward. Yeah, just to that line. Perfect.
So basically, hips forward prevented you from the backflip.
Yeah, I can show you what happens if you don't use your hips.
Oh.
That's it.
Beautiful. It's actually a very accurate fall. Yeah. You see? That's control. Okay. Now your turn.
I like that I saw that because now it makes sense in my brain.
Right here. This is the one. Go. Yeah, it looked great. Now we gotta add a little more distance, get more comfortable with it.
More distance? Hopefully. No grabbing things yet?
No, not yet.
Okay.
I like them.
So don't worry about where your hands are, just make sure you re-grab so you don't fall off. Because there's a lot to think about, there's a lot to learn. I've been doing this for years and I still don't know everything.
Right.
I can't even claim to have like the best form or anything.
Right.
But as we learn, it's keeping it simple, toes to hips, and re-grabbing for safety. You're good. You were freaked out, so you just forced it to happen.
Yeah.
It still works. Because really what happens is if your body forces the move, you're gonna naturally pop your hips.
Yeah. He's a great teacher.
Yeah.
Thank you, Caleb.
Yeah.
For the lache, we have to bring our toes just a little higher on the throw. So we're popping the hips, and then we're gonna try to grab the next bar like a T-Rex, locked off. Right here, pop the hips.
Oh, yeah.
Fantastic.
You're so amazing.
That was great.
Yeah.
Nice job. Okay, we're going farther now.
Okay, no, never mind.
You already did it for 3 feet.
Wow.
Good job.
Okay, it looks smooth.
And you're not gonna know instantly how everything feels. This is muscle memory we're building up. But you're improving, and that's really what matters. One thing I was saying is if we weren't doing a really quick course, I'd make her do 4 feet for like a week in different variations and stuff just to get super comfortable with it.
Yeah.
Make sure you pop the hips, okay?
Easy cake.
Oh, she could have did
like
7.
Is she ready for 6?
She is ready for 6.
Come on, 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 come on. Go, beautiful!
It's gonna happen, I'm gonna land.
Okay, that's 1. And here's 2. Let's go right here.
That's big. Nice. It looks very beautiful. Any corrections, coach?
I mean, she's got to, you know, get more comfortable with it, but she's popping her hips, and that's what matters.
Wow, how did it feel?
That was so good. He's such a good teacher.
I spent hours
yeah.
to explain it, and I couldn't, because really? I probably just don't have experience to explain such a specific move. So this is your PR. This is the rig.
Yeah,
so.
I think I'm good for now.
Good? You want to
I gotta practice yet more.
You gotta learn to re-grab. If you don't re-grab, you're eventually gonna fall off the bar, and that doesn't feel good. Use your hips. And the biggest thing is start small. Learn how to do it in a very small space. It's really fun even starting small, and then go bigger slowly from there.
Okay, I stuck probably at 13, 14 feet,
mm-hmm.
and I just can't go through. You wanna see my technique?
Sure, yeah, yes? Absolutely.
Okay.
Let's go. Nice swing, come on, lean forward.
Ooh, nice.
I think it's not safe for my shoulders. No?
You gotta figure out how to translate all that shock into just more swing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which maybe you're doing that and it's still just a lot of shock. Maybe you're not warmed up.
That's true.
We did 13 for our first lache.
13?
This is our first one, right?
Yeah, yeah. Is it much?
I'm doing laches a bit farther and I don't warm up with 13 usually, you know
really?
What I mean? I would warm up with like 7, 8 and then go to like 12 and then 13,
okay,
14.
Yeah. It's a Magnus influence. No warm up, just go for it. Did you even try?
No.
What's your PR?
16.
16?
Yeah.
Want a PR today?
Sure, why not?
The form is beautiful, right?
Yeah, she's so good. Mm-hmm. And you see how she falls? I need to learn how to do that.
Yeah, to absorb all impact and all power.
Yeah, rolling. Mm-hmm.
Mm. Yeah.
All right, Ash, let's go, let's go! First try, come on!
Come on, Ash! Go! Woo! That was such a good fall.
This is common in every swinging sport, parkour and gymnastics, is after you tuck or tap for your backswing, mm-hmm. you need to make sure you hit a point where you push everything fully away from the bar. Uh-huh. Right, because you're pushing that backswing up, but if you stay scrunched to go back into your swing, you're losing some momentum. So scrunch up for your backswing, pike or arch, and then push it all away before you go.
I'll do one more.
Okay.
But I'm not going to grab.
Okay. And as much as you can.
Push. There you go.
Oh, good.
Yeah, it felt
good.
Yeah. Once you figure out the timing of that.
Took so much focus to push away that I forgot to let go on it.
Yeah.
Right. That's down. How I feel about my hips. I focus so much on my
hips. Yeah. Because everything goes so fast, right? Cake. Cake.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm going pretty straight.
Nice shot. Yes. Come on, Anton, let's go. Use that backswing. Push. Oh, my God.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm feeling fine. Yeah.
Come on, you got it.
I know.
Come on.
Just commit. Let's go.
Push. Come on. Come on, hold on to that.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, cheering helps a lot. It's like, if I won, like, was by myself in the gym, it took me half an hour. The world record on the gymnastics bars is Ashley Watson. It's 19, almost 20 feet, 19 and a half, I think, on the parkour bar. Is still Najee Richardson,
yeah,
18 and a half. I need a pro tip for 15 foot Lache.
Backswing higher.
Backswing higher?
Yeah.
I feel, to be honest, I feel that I'm too heavy, and when I go down, I squeeze so much that I'm just gonna lose my skin on the first bar. It never happened with me though, but
right.
I genuinely feel on the backswing.
Like you're dead.
It's not gonna happen.
So what I learned and how to like get rid of that feeling, because I literally felt like I was dead on every backswing I ever did. That's why I never maxed out. If you learn how to wait to bring your toes back, so you're gonna extend,
mm-hmm.
and then as you go through, you don't bring your toes back here, you bring your toes back after you pass the middle of your swing. And then mm-hmm. you bring your toes back. It takes a long time to learn, but it gets rid of that feeling of like you're dead. It's weird.
Yeah.
Oh my
God. Nice. That's good. That's impressive.
Thank you.
It looks fun.
Thank you. Yeah, it's fun.
And you told you. I mean, like, how tall are you? 6?
I'm 5'10".
No, you're not. I'm 5'10", no, but I'm looking at you from
shoulders.
The down. No?
Yeah? 5'10"?
No. I don't know.
No, they're the same.
No!
What about hands? I mean, you have a wingspan better, right?
Mine's pretty big.
I'm back to back with this foot. Yeah, unless
you want to hug. Oh,
hold on.
Caleb's got his arms bent and he's already longer.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, you have a couple inches.
I think I have, yeah.
Half a foot.
Come on. Is that action? Yes!
Yeah.
That is!
No.
No.
It's so far. No, it's already one foot and it feels untouchable. We have a different bodies, but we need to have the same result, so.
Come on, all your power on the startup as well. Go! Come on!
Come on!
Push and throw! Come on!
No, I don't feel it. I lost it.
You got it. Come on! Hit it! Let's go!
No,
nice.
I feel
tired. Yeah.
I feel exactly the same move when I go on the extension and I start squeezing the bar.
Yeah.
And I feel that it's not gonna happen, you know? It's always interesting to see it from the different perspective,
you know,
and from different coaches and athletes, what's actually the mistakes or tips or tricks or the learning process. But it's always kind of on the surface. You just have to work hard, train hard more than you think. And if you think that you work hard and you're not getting a result, it means that you're not. And of course, like a lot of people say, you just have to compete with yourself. But having someone who is a little bit better than you at something is always helpful. It's just like push you forward.
Oh, so close. eventually you're gonna find your limit, right? So that's where you push the limit, and something a little less than your limit can feel so easy when your limit's just that far away from it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, get it. Come on, dude.
Nice, John. Yo, that felt so different.
So what I was doing before was I was arching super hard and extending, but I was staying in this arched position.
Mm-hmm.
That time I really focused on trying to hollow out and straighten my body to get those hips up higher and then drop back in and explode with more power. And I just had a lot more than I expected.
Let's go, come on. Come on.
Ah, so close!
You touched it. I think I saw you touched it.
Yeah, I hit my head on the top beam up there so hard.
Oh no, did you hit it hard?
Kinda.
Are you bleeding?
No.
What can you say about bicycle kick?
There hasn't been like a lot of research on it, but it's a fun technique and I think it gives a lot of power. I mean, the results say a lot, so.
I think you have to be like, your back's supposed to be very flexible for that.
Yeah? Maybe, yeah, we see a lot of
people. It's not for old people.
I think that helps because one foot brings the first amount of power and then the second foot drives through. And I think that it just gives you more power when you swing, personally.
So you think it's more powerful?
Yes.
Okay, I want to try it.
Yeah, it feels weird. The backswing kind of normal.
Yeah.
Normal and then?
Yeah. The backswing is where your...
Yeah. Oh my god, no, it's so weird.
It looks
so weird. It's so weird.
Yeah, so I drive with my left foot first, and then my right foot brings it through. And yes.
Oh my god.
Yeah!
Oh my god, this is extremely weird. Mm-hmm.
Does it throw you off any when you do that mixed grip on your backswing?
He's so practiced at it.
Yeah.
That's cool, like technique. I can't say if I like it because I actually didn't feel it. It's like grab a cake and miss your like face.
did
you like the cake? I mean, I touched it, but I don't know the taste. It feels so different, but he just threw himself like on his like body like length.
Yeah,
that's good. I wasn't planning on doing this tonight, but it was fun.
Thank you, I appreciate you so much.
Oh yeah, man, appreciate you guys coming out. That was awesome.
Thank you for the coaching. It was really good.
Yes,
the best. Thank you.
Come on.
Again, there is no secrets, like always hard work and practice will give you results that you deserve. Well, thank you for your time, I really appreciate it. I hope you guys learned something new. Don't forget to hit everything that needs to be hit, and hope you like the video and see you on next one.